Welcome to a new test and teardown video. This time it's an oscilloscope, or like they called it in 1954, oscillograph. This one is from Philips. The type number is GM5654. It's a 3 megahertz oscilloscope, one channel. And according to Radio Museum, it contains 15 tubes and weighs 26 kilos. I measured it to 25 kilos. I checked both fuses and voltage settings should be correct, but I think this is actually the on-off switch. But I don't measure any resistance or connectivity between the two connectors on the back for mains input, so I think nothing is going to happen. Let's look at the back. So this is the back side. It can handle a lot of different voltages, 150 watts, so that is quite nice. I think this is the voltage indicator. I can't see what voltage it is set for, so I need to take out the case. We got two fuses and I checked those are nice. We got vertical, horizontal, is this input or output or something like that? So what exactly is this supply something? So you can maybe, what is this? Is this input or output? I don't know yet, but I'm going to find out. Horizontal can be, okay, so this is the external horizontal or internal. And then there is a connector for some external equipment called GM4188, whatever that is. And this looks like a DC connector or something like that. Really nice. Metal protection. Well, let's try and look inside before we power this up. Oh no, this is exactly what happens sometimes. I know this is not the first time I've seen this. Somebody stole all the tubes. Ha ha. It is completely ripped. Look at that. So there's no way we can power this up. But at least we can see. Oy, 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 this, look, there's a terrible smell. But look at something funny. This is definitely the high voltage. Oh, look at the dust. You can see the, I don't know if you can see this, but can you see the traces or tracks of dirt here? It's definitely due to high voltage. Oy, oy, oy. Completely cracked. Obviously, this is total trash. Somebody did unplug this, so I guess they tried to take out the. Ooh, it's completely loose. Ooh, we can even. What? It is that loose, and I didn't even drop it. Oh, look at that. So that is the tube. It's a DG106. Wow. Beautiful. I don't really see any lines or any bad. Only a little bit. What have we got in here? Oh, this is so heavy. Wow, look at that monster transformator. Whew, What is that? Some sort of a special homemade fuse, right? And that is some very, very special homemade inductor or something. Ooh-hoo-hoo. Yes. There's a reason why somebody took out all the tubes, and that is definitely because this it is not working. See? This one can't be good. Okay, so this is a high voltage capacitor. Before we of course not. Do I need to mention the stink here is powerful? But like you see here, we see completely blown up components all over the place. What exactly is this? Oh, so this connector here at the back. Look at that. Whoa. Really? This is the tube. High voltage connector. And this goes directly to the back. What? And here is the anode supply. So there's a looped back connector here. This is a really, really sexy high voltage connector of the really, really nasty, nasty high voltages. Wow, I did not expect that. So that means you can input or output the anode voltage, really? This is the left side of the scope. Okay, we got a lot of capacitors here, and everything is just hanging and dingly dangly here. Maybe somebody tried to rip this. So this is definitely the high voltage supply. See? We have some really, really nice rectifier diodes or a high voltage PL something tubes here, right? Really good sized fuse holders. So that is super nice. That is one huge transformator. That was, ooh, hoo, hoo, hoo. It was completely burned. See? The smoke is here. There's some, yep. I don't know if this is visible on the video, but that is smoked as well, so. Yeah, this is just trash. Oh, somebody tried to fix something here with a more modern diode. And the components are just hanging like this. I think we should have a look at the bottom. So what exactly happened here at the bottom? Somebody was playing. Oh, we got some other diodes here. So this is where they played around with some stuff, and here we got the two. Oh, this is probably a rectifier tube, right? And that will be the filament for the rectifier tube, and that will be the two cathodes. So yeah. So they didn't have this tube, and then they tried with some diodes and fantastic things. Well, I think this capacitor here is really cute. I would like to have a look at that one. Here we got some more capacitors down there in the middle. We also got a big nice capacitor here. Let's have a look at that. So that will be the input attenuator. an input amplifier tube. What is trimmer trimmer? Where exactly was this stored? Oh, look at that. $19.54, huh? Let's see if we can get this capacitor out as well. The other one here is really, really cute. So that is 1 microfarad, 3,400 volts. And that is heavy duty. I can't wait to measure this. Somebody wrote here, is this 68, right? So that's what I think. Maybe it was replaced or they just repaired. Are you kidding me? I wouldn't call this the most service friendly unit. Just to get all these different units out, you need to have like screws from up and from down and from this and that. There's a very funny detail here, is one of the tubes. So this is an EF91 and it was mounted in a completely flimpity flimsy socket. So this is definitely to avoid the microphone effect. And this tube, look at that. Super, super nice, huh? So this, whoopsie doopsie. So here in the middle, we had this capacitor system mounted. Normally, you can be lucky to find some date or year codes on some of those capacitors, but I don't see that here. What is that? Is that a seal of some sort in those two? And here we got, say, a leak, right? So they leaked. Yeah. But that is a funny capacitor I want to get out. It's only 16 microfarad, 250 volts, so. But anyway, I want to take it out and see if I can measure that one. This one is really nice. Super, super heavy, by the way. There's no. Normally, you'll see a seal up here. I'm going to wash this here. We've got glass. Really, really beautiful capacitors. So those two, they will go to my funny capacitor collection. And the rest is gonna go straight to hell. Yeah. By the way, that's gonna be really, really fast now because the smell here is intense. So I cleaned those capacitors. Oh, really, really nice for my collection. So this one is 1 microfarad. And the other one should be 16, but I measured it to 17. Let's try the other one. Whoa, really? This one is from 1954. Oh, let's try and measure the series resistance in this one, huh? What? So this is at 100 kilohertz. Look at that. 10 kilohertz. And of course now, it's the XC that is playing in here, right? But anyway, got a really, really low series resistance. How about we check out the other one as well? So this one should be 16 microfarad. Of course, it is not designed for this kind of frequency. Yep, here we go. Oh, that is insane. Look at that. That is not that bad at all. All right. I got some good things from my collection.